Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to be talking about what to do after a chiropractic adjustment. Now, very first thing I want to get into is disclaimer. This is not medical advice. This is just based on personal experience, having met many chiropractors, having had many adjustments myself, and having had a partner who was able to walk again after being told she would never walk after a cardiac arrest from chiropractic care being one of the main causes of her regaining her ability to walk, and what we needed to learn, what we needed to go through. Because I don't know about you, if you've been to chiropractors, every single one practice is slightly different. Many of them don't really offer much after service advice or care what you need to do instantly after an adjustment. Some do, some don't. But I'm going to tell you what I learned from my personal experience and what helped. Firstly, is as soon as you've had your chiropractic adjustment, you might find yourself being slightly dizzy, slightly disorientated. And what this is it appears to be a recalibration of the body's perception of its environment, because you have just changed the nervous system's structure and how you function in your reality. Because your central nervous system is the controls and coordinates every action of your body. So if it's adjusted, you're going to have to recalibrate every action that your body takes. So what we did is we went for a 20-minute walk. Now, 20 minutes being the minimum amount of time to take a walk and to make sure during that walk that your head is up. I like to visualize an arrow coming out of the center of my chest and an arrow coming out between my eyes, making sure both of them are parallel to each other. Yeah? So my chest is up and forwards and my eyes are forwards. And walking with loose shoulders, really making sure them shoulders are nice and loose, that your arms swing, that you've got a good stride in your walk, that you're just walking with comfort and with ease. And like I said, if you can get out in nature and do a barefoot walk, oh, even better, amazing. Your feet are full of nerve endings, and how your body's perception to your central nervous system is connected to the feet and how they perceive the environment is crucial. So barefoot walking for 20 minutes will be amazing for you if you've just had an adjustment to make it hold. If you're finding you're getting many adjustments over and over again and it never seems to hold, what are you doing after an adjustment? Drop a comment, let me know, what do you do after a chiropractic adjustment? Have you found that you go for adjustment and then you need another one the next day, the next week? How's your experience with chiropractic been? Has it changed your life like it has mine? Now, that's one thing, is walking. Now, to hold the position, to hold the body, if you've been out of alignment for a long time, I found that you have some tendons, some muscles that are overactivated and some that are underactivated. And when you get this adjustment, suddenly one side's weak and one side's over strong, and it just pulls back into place exactly how it was before. Especially if it's been a long-term condition, not like an accident or something. Something that's been there for many years. So you need to re-strengthen and re-stretch certain areas. And I found that Pilates is excellent for this. Pilates re-strengthens a balanced body, yeah, and gets you back into that. So you can go on YouTube and watch Pilates for beginners. Yeah, and start practicing that daily if possible, 30 minutes, and it'll really help your life, it'll really help your body, and it'll really help them chiropractic adjustments hold. I've also found yoga to be a great way to open the central nervous system, doing correct yoga. And again, certain postures, you don't want to go advanced if you've never done it before, because certain things are very twisted, you look like a pretzel, yeah, and you won't be able to get into positions, and you might find yourself getting into more pain. So again, if you go join a club, go join a center that practices these things to use someone else's expertise, but you can follow basic beginner lessons online for free. There's loads on YouTube. Try them out, they're very good for opening the nervous system. Look at nerve flossing, type that in YouTube, nerve flossing. These exercises are great at moving the nervous system. But Pilates, yoga, these things really do help. And again, just being consciously aware of your posture and your attitude. You look at a child, when you say something bad to a child, their whole body collapses. So if you're saying something bad to yourself all day long, if you're discouraging yourself, if you're mentally beating yourself up, you're reprogramming that posture into a bad position, and you're going to just have more negative impacts on your central nervous system, and you'll be back at that chiropractic office sooner. So practice self-love, gratitude, love, life, and just check out my other videos on self-love. It may be a path that you need to be on. Most need to be on it, and it is a great journey to go on. You will love it, and you will love yourself once you get to a certain stage. It may be uncomfortable, but check out my videos on self-love. Start practicing that daily. Recalibrate your mind so that you hold yourself in a better posture for a longer amount of time. Like I said, Pilates, yoga, self-love. Practice these three things and you'll really help hold a better posture for a longer amount of time. Need less chiropractic adjustments. But if you're having problems, chiropractic care is amazing. From my personal experience, I've seen many chiropractors, osteopaths, all over the world. They're all different, all lovely people, and I've just seen amazing benefits. Like I said, if you check out my other videos, you'll hear more of my story. But it helped me personally. It's got rid of a lot of problems. And what it did for my loved one, Danielle, is unbelievable. We was told she would be dead right now, and she is not. She had a cardiac arrest, then was wheelchair bound for a year on buckets of medication, morphine, everything. She is drug free and she is walking. And she was told that would not happen. She can even run now. She's told she wouldn't walk. So think of that. How incredible is that? Right. Have a great day. Lots of love to you. And enjoy your chiropractic care. Enjoy taking care of your body. Know you deserve great care, great love, great health. See you in the next video. Much love. Don't forget to like and subscribe.